Hi, my name is Corey Sauer. I'm an application engineer at 3M, and I support the structural adhesive portfolio. Substrates and adhesives is probably the most complicated question because it depends so dramatically on everything else that you need. So the overall performance requirements of the adhesive will also be chosen based on temperatures, environmental conditions, overall strength that you need, process conditions, like how fast you need it to cure. So the consideration of whether you need to prep a substrate will depend a lot on the type of adhesive that you choose. And even within substrates, there's different grades of substrates. Not all ABS is ABS, so you may not be able to issue a blanket statement on how you would prep that surface. So that being said, there is a lot better information online than I could give you in 2 minutes here. But there's probably four main categories to consider substrates in. So number one is metals, because they have a really high surface energy, so adhesives will readily wet out if it's a clean, dry surface. The second is what we call traditional materials, so it's things like glass, wood, leather, concrete. They've got like that middle range of surface energies, but there's usually some unique factor about them to consider, like the roughness or any oils on the leather or hydrolysis of a glass. And then there's two families of plastics. So number one is the engineering plastics, which tend to be the higher surface energy, higher performing ones like acrylic, polycarbonate, ABS, epoxy resin composites. And then the final one is the low surface energy plastics, which is the commodity type plastics, polypropylene, polyethylene. Those are low surface energy. And also things like fluorinated, polytetrafluoroethylene, and silicones. Those are the really low surface energies. So within that, you know, there's different adhesive chemistries that would bond to each one, and you know, not even metals are the same. So with metals, you may have aluminum versus copper. So aluminum is a passivated metal. It's fairly inert, whereas copper is still an active metal, so it has the ability to corrode. So even with surface prep considerations, you may want to consider, is there going to be degradation over time from the corrosion? Traditional materials, when you have things like natural leather that have oils in them from the tanning process that will leach into the adhesive over time that could plasticize it and degrade the bond. Or like I mentioned, glass with hydrolysis, so moisture penetration is sensitive when you have an adhesive glass bond. Engineering plastics are really unique because it's not just about the surface energy. The adhesive may wet out across the surface, but its ability to bond will also be dictated by the crystallinity of the plastic or the polarity of the plastic. So you have a material like nylon, which is fairly high surface energy, you'll wet it out, but it's really crystalline and not that polar. So when you look at some of the mechanisms of adhesion, many of the adhesives may bond initially, but then over time, you'll still see adhesive failure unless you do some more rigorous prep. And then the polyolefins and the low surface energy plastics are kind of an animal in themselves because you will need to do either priming, some kind of corona treatment, or use a specialty adhesive that's designed to kind of penetrate into that plastic and create an entangled bond with the polymer of the substrate itself. So all of those things then still will not answer, is that surface prep adequate? You'll typically still need to do testing. You'll need to do prototyping to make sure you're doing the right thing. So the next steps that you would do if you were looking at a specific substrate, I would say first off is to go to our website because there is a lot of really good content about how to think about substrates in each of those four families. And I think it's around the top 10 within each. So if you look at engineering plastics, it's kind of the top 10 most popular engineering type plastics and the considerations you should take. The second thing I would suggest is to look at technical data pages of the adhesives that you're looking at. Because those tech data pages will have adhesion to a lot of different substrates, and they'll report two things. So you'll see, you'll typically see a number. So it's either an overlap shear number or a peel number showing the overall strength in pounds per square inch, megapascals, or pounds per inch in peel. But you'll also see a failure mode. So if you look at the failure mode and you see that it's cohesive failure, that means that that adhesive tested under those conditions remained bonded to both the substrates after it pulled to failure versus adhesive failure, which would indicate that it peeled cleanly from one of those substrates. So you can use that as a guide on whether it's sufficient. And then the third thing to do is to reach out. So if you do have a specific substrate or there's considerations about some, some additives to it and whether it's migrating into the adhesive, our technical team in 3M can look at those things. We'll do technical service requests to help you understand which adhesives over the duration of the part may be a better option. I hope this was helpful. I'm always happy to talk about adhesives. So I hope you enjoyed watching and you're going to get some use out of it.